evening, everybody.
Amen.
Okay, this year we are very privileged and thankful to the team. Joyce Ang, she is the leader of the team. Her husband is the elder of a Sungai-Way Gospel Center. Together with their two girls and another one of their intern, they are here to bless our children. So I pass the time over.
Good evening, uncles and aunties, boys and girls. Our camp team is a strong in the school.
Jesus said, I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who remain in me and I in them will produce much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. John 15, verse 5.
During this camp, we have learned to grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and glow by bearing the fruit of the Spirit.
We are to let our light shine before men that they may see our good works and glorify the Father in heaven.
Let us now welcome the little ones as they present the song, The Fruit of the Spirit, followed by the singing part.
Thank you. Maya would like to share with us what the children would like us adults to pray for them.
Hi, my name is Shamaya. I would like to share some of the problems and issues which we are facing nowadays. Even at this age, we are facing a lot of stress from overloaded school homework and tuition homework. Sometimes we have to stay up too late at night just to complete our homework. Some parents also have extremely high expectations on their children. Therefore, they can only find comfort in their caretaker or people they meet online, as well as electronic gadgets, which also lead to them feeling insecure. We also face issues of bullying in the way of either physically or verbally. Even now, my school is looking out for the issue of cyberbullying. As you can see, there is someone who wrote, "How to forgive people who call you bad names? What did Jesus say about forgiving people?" Well, Ephesians chapter 4 verse 32 says, "Be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another as God in Christ forgave you."
Thank you so much, Shamaya. Isn't that very telling? Parents, have got a lot of reflecting to you. Stretch out your hands also upon the children. You know, they have shared their struggles, the expectation put on them. Let's pray that God will set them free from that. And pray for ourselves as parents as well. Huh?
Lord, we want to thank you for this gift of children to our midst. For each and every child that is gathered here. Maybe so, Lord, even as we stand here as adults, as parents, as grandparents, as uncles and aunties, as Bobo and JJ, we want to ask, Lord, that you will pour forth your blessing in each and every one of these precious ones. Lord, we pray that you will lead them to a personal knowledge of Jesus Christ. Lord, even from a young age, they will learn to trust in Jesus. They will learn in their heart that how much you love them above everything else. And they will learn even from young to read your word. They will learn from young to love your word. They will learn from young to honor you and to trust you and allow you to have the first place in their heart. So Lord, we want to praise you for each and every of these children. We want to pray that, Lord, that none of them will ever walk away from you all the days of their life. And we want to claim this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.